only way out is through. Swift as my feet can carry me.
Since this one hid for days as the sounds of battle got closer and closer to town. You didn't even care who won, so long as it ended. Before the shadows, there was once a house full of warmth and children's laughter in this one's life. No more.
Easy.
Never a dull moment. No one back home will ever believe this.
Greetings. Greeting. It is over where I am concerned. It is through, yet I do not reckon the next resolution may not end in her favor.
Listen, I'm never going back. If you said I don't expect anyone to understand that. But I've been dealt a hand most people don't have to con- Thanks, soldier. Your support means I- You really are the best of the best. Of the best.
That face, you know.
I fought at his side once, shortly after my conversion. Before the battle, he was everything a general should be. A charismatic leader with a brilliant strategic mind. And when the fighting began, he led his troops from the front and cut through the enemy like a scythe through stalks. Blows and arrows rained down on him, and before long, his face was a mask of blood. But he did not fall. He did not even falter. This battle, like most, will be won or lost before the fighting begins. There is a connection to this night song of Balthazar's, whatever or whoever it might be. We must find it and destroy it. Admirable ambition. Then let us go forth and conquer.
What? On one hand, they seem useful. But on the other hand, or perhaps tentacle before long, we know where they're coming from and what lies at the end of that path. I never expected Seramorphosis to be tempting. I think we should resist these powers. There's simply too many unknowns for us to risk it. And some might say eels and turnips boiled in milk is a delicacy, but some are fools. I'll make my own mind up.
Fine. What's on your mind? If nothing else, you can at least soak up any arrows that are loosed at us.
Pity. You'd started off so well saving my life aboard the Nautiloid. I suppose now I'm seeing the real you.
You already know my biggest secret. What more can you ask? What, besides my life's calling and the greatest problem I've ever faced? Well, I like night orchids and can't swim. Is that the sort of thing you meant? It's a deal. No, I can't.
Quite literally, I mean.
If I manage to return to Baldur's Gate and fulfill Shah's mission, then that is not for you to know. Leave it at that. What?
How can I help? I've no doubt she has the power to do so, but as for the permission, Ao would not look kindly on her meddling in mortal affairs. As for Elminster, he saved the realms more times than legend can recount. But to take on a god is no easy feat, even for him. My orb is the best chance we have, and only I can wield it. Oh, you know me, ever the optimist. Truth is, I was living on borrowed time already. If anything, I feel more at peace than I have in months. At least now I know my death will have purpose. Won't be a distant bang in the foot. She expects, though. I doubt she's asked many of her. She wouldn't ask such a thing if it weren't our only means of survival. However much she's annoyed at me. Alas, no. Making myself invulnerable, immortal, or in any other fashion unkillable would render it useless. Still, I see no harm in learning what we can about this night song. And if we manage to find it, the harm...
Hello, my sweet.
I'm a bit busy at the moment. We'll talk later.
No!
trust no one.
I've got a long road ahead.
On one hand, they seem useful. But on the other hand, and some might say eels and turnips boiled in milk is a delicacy. But some are fools.
What are you thinking about? Hey, soldier. About that tadpole. Glad to see you haven't gone down the tadpole slurping route yet. We still don't know if that visitor has our best interests in mind. It's a free party, but I won't lie, that's a concern, do they? I'm not sure either of us can say one way or the other. We don't know what the costs might be. Good. And you know, keep an eye on yourself.
The shadows are cruel. It would take a miracle for Arabella's mother and father to survive them. Well, lucky for us, we've got a...
Because there's nothing to tell. She died when I was born. As a boy, my bond with father was too deep to miss the mother I never had. Now, well, I'd be lying if I said I'd never thought about my mother. What life would have been like if she'd lived? Maybe I'd be living in the city. Maybe I'd never have been forced into this cursed pact. But there's no use lingering on maybes. My mind is on the story.
Hey, you. I made it. Easy peasy. You find Mum and Pops? Well, hurry. They've got to be somewhere. Then I'll teach you to conjure those vines. Before you were this.
There is no before.
thoughts are back on the twisted Skeletas and his honeyed...
Oh, my nauseating lord, such rudeness is unbecoming of your august station. I come here, for I wish to bring you another powerful tithe. But I cannot grant you this prize quite yet. You must do something divinely unspeakable first. You will receive a royal prize for killing this pretty girl. Isabel, the cleric with the sweetest face of the moon. She is too precious to live. Oh, Master, consider the tiny mishap with the bard you had the last time we met. Hmm? Your unconscious clever mind hungers for extreme violence. Who knows who you might kill next if you do not satisfy your urge? Be true to yourself, my lord.